FTP is very useful when building your WordPress website. In this video, I'm gonna guide you step by step how to install and use FTP. And I'm also gonna guide you through how you can get your FTP credentials from SiteGround, CPanel, DirectAdmin, and Plesk. Let's dive into it right now. Let's go to FileZilla. And then you go to the FileZillaProject.org. Then we go to download the FileZilla client, but don't press this button because this installer may include bundled offers. Go to show additional download options over there. And if you're using Windows, you can use this version. If it doesn't run and you get an error message, you can use this version. If you're on Mac, choose this one. And on Linux, you can choose this one. Press on this one and run the installer. I agree. Anyone who uses this computer, press next. And you want all these things and press next. Next again. And we're going to install it. It has been installed. And let's start it up. Welcome to FileZilla. Don't be intimidated by this program. It is really easy. You have to see is your local site. This is actually your own PC. And then you have your remote site. So the website we will be connecting to. And you can transfer files between the two of them, or you can just edit your remote files. How you can connect to your remote website? You can go to the site manager over here or file site manager. As you can see, there is nothing here. Press new site. Where do we get all this information? The host, the port, the logon type, the user, and the password. Well, you go to your hosting company. Within SiteGround, you can just use the tool finder over there and just type in FTP. Here you go. Or you can also go to site and go to FTP accounts. It's the same way. For example, just FTP at wpressdoc.com. Generate a strong password. Copy it, of course. And then we press create. Now it has been created. And then you're gonna, first of all, paste the password over there. Then what we need is the FTP login information. So we need the ftp.wpressdoc.com. This is our host name. So we're going to copy this one, go in FileZilla, and we're going to paste it in over there, host name. Then you also see a port. It's called 21. Copy it, go to FileZilla, and paste it in over there. Then we have the account name, which is this one. This is our username. And we're going to paste it in over there. And actually, now we have everything set up. So we can just press connect over there. This is fine, no problem at all. Just press OK. And then we are at our website. It's unbelievable. As you can see, we have the remote site, wpressdoc.com. You can press on it. Then you can go see logs, websats. But what you need is public HTML. Now, this always looks a little bit different on different sites. I'm going to show you in just a bit. If you just press public HTML, then it looks something like this. We have the wp-admin, wp-content, and wp-includes. And if you scroll down, you can see even more files, which are wp-config.php, wp-mail. All these things are WordPress itself. Now the wp-content folder, if you double click on it, you will go to this one. And this is actually the place where all your your themes lives here, your plugins lives here, your cache, your uploads. These are all the folders, all the things you have been uploaded to your website. And if you just want to go up one, just press on this, double click the dots, and you go back. Now, once, for example, a plugin has gone rogue or broke, you go to plugins. So in this example, we're using Better WP Security or iThemes. iThemes is a very good plugin to secure your website. If you haven't done so, check out this tutorial because you really need to secure your WordPress website right now. It's very important. But let's say I've locked myself out. I cannot go anymore inside of my WordPress website. Then I can just rename this to broken, for example. And now the plugin has been turned off and I can log into my website again. But what if my plugin has been, I don't know, it has been broken and I want to re-upload it again? You can, of course, do it via WordPress manually. But what if you cannot go into WordPress anymore? Then you need to upload the files manually. First thing, you get the plugin file and download it to your computer. that is this file. Then you need to extract all these files from the zip file in a folder. I have done that, it is over there. And here you can see the folder of is exactly the same as this one. So what do you do right now to overwrite all the files, right click and press upload over there. Then it says it already exists. What do you want to do? I want to override them all and always use this action for now and press OK. As you can see now, the transfer will start and it will upload all these files onto my server. And this will take some time. There's only 1200 files to go, so this could take a while. And voila, it has been file transfer successful. And now all the files has been transferred to our website. Congratulations, now you know how this works. It also works the other way around. If you go to WP content and you go, for example, to uploads, then you see years, and in years you see months. You go to your month. Oh, this one is empty. And here we can see all kind of things that I have been uploaded for my latest tutorial, how to make the Apple website. For example, I have here the MacBooks file. If I want this one on my computer, I just drag and drop it over there like this, or I right click and press download. And when I press open, you can see the MacBooks I've uploaded to my website. One more thing I want to show you with FTP. If we now go to themes, you can see the themes we have been creating. I have a child theme and I have another theme, 2022. I'm going to remove that because I don't use it. So I press delete and I press yes and start deleting all the files one by one. Then it's gone. You go to your child theme and you go to functions.php because you want to change something. You can do it, of course, via WordPress, but you can also change it like this and press view edit over there. And then it opens up Notepad and here you can change the functions.php of your website. If I now change something and I close this, it will say you want to save it. Yes, save it. And then what I really like about FileZilla is it automatically says to me, a file has been changed. Do you want to upload this file back to the server? And then you press yes. And then all the things you have changed in your file will be transferred immediately to your website. Now, if you want to disconnect from your server, just press this icon over here. Disconnects from the currently visible server. Press it. Now we are disconnected. If you now again want to make the new connection again, just go to the site manager and then you have your new site. Well, of course, we're going to rename this because this is the website wpress.com. And then we're gonna click somewhere. And if you now want to connect to your website, just press connect and it will establish a connection. And here we are back in again. This is also very useful if you want to add more websites. Go to the site manager and you can add a new site. Now, cPanel is used with a lot of different hosting companies. I really don't like it because I think it's really old, but it actually works. Then you just type in your function FTP over here, or you can just scroll down and you go to files FTP accounts. Click on it and you can see almost the same thing as we've saw with SiteGround, and this is our username. So let's make this don't forget to like, and then our domain will be this one. And then you need to create a password. Make sure it is a strong password because I've created a tutorial where we couldn't find why we have been hacked and the FTP account was the problem. You can use this password generator to do so. Click on this one, copy it. Copy it, use password, and then it's very strong. This is the directory where you want to go. In this case, it is one website, and it's actually my sub website, which is don't forget to like. You can leave it like this, or you can delete this entirely if you want to go to it. And then you press create FTP account over there, how it has been created. If you want to see your information, how to log in, press on configure FTP client. And now we have here the FTP username, the server, and the port. Just go back to FileZilla. We're gonna add a new website. And this is, I think it was dvdoctor.com. And then we're gonna, first of all, paste it in over there. Then we go back, we go to the configure button. We're gonna use the FTP username, fill it in over there. with all the thing, the entire, it looks like an email address, but it's not. We're gonna use the FTP server. We're gonna paste it in over there at the host. And the port is again 21 because it's the standard FTP port. Don't change anything at all, or just press OK. And if you want to connect to it through the site manager and press connect, or you just drop it down and then you click on it and then it will be connected. However, when I do so now, this is what it says. FileZilla is already connected to a server. Now you can abort the other connection, disconnect it, or you can establish connection in a new tab. And if I press this one, now we have two tabs in which you can connect to your servers. It actually works really good and really fast. Now if something comes up like this, could not connect to the server, it's going to retry it automatically and then it's going to try to resolve it. However, I've moved my websites from NameHero to SiteGround again because I really don't like NameHero. I had a lot of problems with it. Connecting to this will not work, but I wanted to show you how it does. However, if you see these errors, you might see also that your login information is not correct. Maybe your password, maybe the host, or maybe something else. Double check it, copy and paste it again, and try again. Now, I don't want to connect to this one, so I'm going to close this tab over there. And I'm also going to disconnect this server. So now we are not connected to anything. You might also have seen this in your hosting. It is DirectAdmin, which also is a system used a lot by hosting companies. First of all, you just go simply here to FTP management over there, click on this one, and then you press create FTP account. It's actually quite the same as the other ones, but it's just a little bit different. It looks a little bit different. Create your username, W press doctor, create a random password. Over there, we're going to save it. And then we're going to use the root directory domain and press create. You cannot see anything like how to connect to it, what are the settings, etc. This is why I also don't like DirectAdmin. But we can try. Just go to our site manager, add a new website. In this case, it is amusementparksusa.com. And we're going to just fill in the password that I just created and also the account name. I'm going to copy it as a user. And then we have to find the host. What is our host? Well, in DirectAdmin, you cannot see it over here how to connect to it. So we go back to home. You can go to DNS management over there. Click on this one. And then you see all these important things in which it will be connected to. You're looking for FTP like this, and this is an IP address, so you can just copy this one, go to FileZilla, go to host and paste it in. And the port, well, you can use 21. Well, let's try. Press connect. Always trust this certificate in future sessions. That will be okay. And press okay. Our connection is established. We're logging in. It's amazing. It works. If you go to public HTML, you will see again WP content includes and everything else. The Plesk system almost works exactly the same as the other management systems we've seen. Just click on your website you want to use, go to FTP access over there, and then you can press this blue button which says add a FTP account. Then we're just going to name it. Don't change anything here. Generate a password and press OK. Then you go back to FileZilla and we're going to add the website name. And then we're going to first paste in the password, of course, type in the user, which in our case is wpressdoc. And then you have to find the host within Plesk. Now, you cannot see the host anywhere here that is easy to copy and paste. You just click on your website over there. And then you click on this one. And here we can see what you need to do. You have the database, you have your password, and you have your IP address. We are going to copy this IP address, copy it, paste it in FileZilla, and then we're just going to use port 21. Press connect, press OK, and here we are. And then we go to HTTP docs, and there is our website with all the things we need to change. What we also use this program for is to change permission of files. As you can see over here, you have permissions, and then you can see what kind of permissions there are on these files. Now, all these numbers mean different kind of things, but if you've seen my iTheme security tutorial, you will notice that you will get error messages if one of these files have, for example, 755 or even 777. Well, how you can change that, just press on one of these files, right click on it, and press File Permissions over there. Click on it, and then you can change your files to, for example, this one is the worst one. Now anybody on the internet can write to this file, but maybe you want this one. So only the owner, the server itself, can write. The group cannot write, and the public can only read and also not do the other things. Then you press OK, and now it has been updated. For example, I'm gonna make this to 777. Press OK, and now this file permission has been changed, as you can see. Let's quickly change it back, because this is not very smart. If you have any questions, drop them down in the comments, and I will be glad to answer them and help you out. Want to see more videos about WordPress or Divi, for example? Hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Have an awesome day.